Hi, I am Dr. Neena Joshi. Today our topic is on the life certificate of pensioners, and this is the first video from that series. Before we begin, let me express my gratitude towards the authorities for their attempts to make every pensioner happy, stress-free and comfortable. Be it about the life certificate or any other grievances or even redressals. So now let us start with the video on life certificates. So life certificates or Jeevan Praman it is called. They were mainly of two types. One was physical, which was age old method, and the second is digital, that is online, that is the latest method. And the one which is coming up, that is I said they were of two types, the third one is coming up very fast. That is a video conference where the bank officer will have video conference with the pensioner who is sitting in his house, and bank officer will be of course in the bank, and they will give the life certificates. It will be issued and generated and sent to the treasury. So that is coming up so fast that maybe next year it will be video conferences for all of us. Let us hope so. So now we will start with physical life certificate because we all are very, very familiar with this. We will finish this very fast. Only the changes in the age-old method I will mention in detail. What was the age-old method? We were going to our branch. Please remember, huh? That time it was branch. Then take the form, fill it, sign, submit, etc. The bank officer will authenticate. The branch will reach it to the treasury and it is done. It looks very nice and sweet. But there were some problems. What were the problems? The pensioner may not remain in the place where his branch is. Like so many pensioners, they relocate somewhere near their children are, or they go to their home place. Then what about their branch? So what they would have to come, they were coming to their branch. Suppose I am in Mumbai and I go to Rajasthan. Then every year I have to come to Mumbai just for signing the certificate. So to avoid that, what the government said, they passed a mandate that you can submit your life certificate at any branch of your bank, but branch can be anything. So wherever I am in India, all over India I can be anywhere, but I will go to a branch nearby my house and submit the life certificate, which was a very great relief to the pensioners. Now the second problem, the loose forms may get lost during the transit because the bank has to send them into the treasury. Of course, it is nobody's fault, but it can happen. So then what will happen? Some pensioners, suppose a form is lost in between, nobody notices and it doesn't reach there, then the pensioner's pension will be stopped for want of the form. So what is the second one? Second betterment was, instead of loose forms, they started sending a register in the branch. I am talking of branch now, okay? So every branch will get a register where the names of all the pensioners of that branch will be written, printed. Pensioner is to go there. If he goes in his own branch, of course, he will go there, find out his name, sign there, bank officer will sign and finish. And the register at the end of the month, generally we do in November, so end of the whatever period it is, it will be sent to the treasury. Now, the question comes about those pensioners who are going to sign in the any branch, not their home branch. So what will they do? They will go in to sign there, but there the register will not have their names because they are not regular account holders there. So what they will do? Nothing, no worries. They will be given a loose form and they will sign in that form and it will be authenticated and it can be sent along with the register to the treasury. Now the problem is, if by chance that loose form is lost, that is what the problem was there last time, then what happens? So to avoid that, what was the third mandate? The third mandate was, that the bank has to give the acknowledgement of the life certificate to the pensioner. That means that both of them are at ease. Pensioner knows that I have submitted the form and there is a proof. Bank will also know that yes, he has submitted. That was a very good thing, and that brought so many problems were solved automatically. Now, about my opinion, the mandate is every bank has to give me, even if I sign in the register, the bank has to give me the acknowledgement. That is fine. Some banks are, they are just signing in the passbook that yes, received. That is easier. Now see, bank people are also very busy, and every person who is signed in the register will say that give me acknowledgement. They don't mind giving, or rather they have to give. But think about it, that if we go in our own branch, suppose, and the register is there where everybody is, there is no loose form for us, for all who are in the branch, and everybody signs there, so the register reaches to treasury, there is no problem. Register cannot disappear like Mr. India. Register has to reach there, so there is no worry. If I go in my own branch and if they are all busy, this is my opinion, okay, that instead of insisting, no, give me acknowledgement because it is my right, we should understand that register is not a problem. Even then, if one wants, one can legally, yes, but I don't think so. Because even bank people are also, they are, you know, we are all grown up. They are like our children. In that time, I will say that, no, give me this, give me that. But I want to say something about the pensioner who signs in other branch. Now, when he signs in the other branch, instead of register, he will be giving a loose form there. Now, when he gives a loose form and it is his right to get the acknowledgement, he should get the acknowledgement, because the loose form, we don't know whether it gets lost or something happens. Now again, I have a suggestion there. Instead of telling everybody that no, I will type, write the acknowledgement and give me and all, the easiest would be, he should take a covering letter with him to the bank and say that, saying or stating that I am from so and so branch and now I am here, so I have come here. Kindly give me my life certificate and acknowledge. So that covering letter, it will be very easy for the bank people to just stamp it and return. So pensioner gets the acknowledgement, and bank is also, as per the whatever mandate, they have also given the acknowledgement. So it is win-win situation for both, and it will be very nice. So this is about the talking of physical life certificate. Now let us talk of the digital life certificate. It is said in short as DLC. This is a revolutionary approach towards life certificate, Jeevan Praman. What is this? This is online, correct? Now when I go to the bank, they know that I have reached, all my documents are with them. When I am submitting online, they don't know whether I am alive or I am not alive. So how will they check whether I am alive? That is why this is Aadhaar based. In Aadhaar, our biometrics are there, like our fingerprints are there and everything is there. So if my fingerprints are taken online by Aadhaar, using Aadhaar, then it is a proof that I was alive on that day. Is it okay? So now this digital life certificate is useful to everyone, especially for those, again, yes, those living in remote areas where the banks are very far. Somebody is in remote area, he wants to go to the branch of his bank which is near his house, but that branch is also not so near because it's very far. They are in remote areas. So that time, the DLC, Digital Life Certificate, will be very simple for him. And what government has done, government has appointed so many authorized agents where they are near everywhere, in every small town, remote areas, they are there. And then they can go to that authorized agent and they can give their life certificate by using Aadhaar. Now we all know how it is taken. We have idea that it is authenticated by our Aadhaar fingerprint, and then we are given the life certificate. So let me explain how this is done. See here, this is generate a life certificate. Yes, one more thing I want to say, that whenever we generate a life certificate using digital method, online method, the life certificate is automatically going to the treasury, because there is a big confusion. People feel that what about treasury, and so many people, they are, you know, worried. So they take DLC, then they don't know whether it is automatically sent. But again, so many times people feel that maybe automatically for central government pensioners, not for state. So they send it to the treasury, they manage to send, they rush, or they post it, or they phone somebody who is near the treasury and please submit my. What happens because of that? See, treasury is already going to get the online life certificate. It is sent to them. See, here I have said that it is sent to the treasury. So then treasury will get it online. Plus the pensioner is worried. So somebody, his relative, will go and send it. Then some will send by Gmail. So the there is so much traffic on the treasury, because the same person, each person sends it by 2-3 ways. Sometimes the pensioner are so worried, they send it to their bank also. So when it is automatically reaching, there is no need. If it is not automatically reaching, I agree that one said, let me reach. So first of all, let us see how it is done, and we can prove here that it is reaching to the treasury. I will show you how. I will prove that it is reaching to the treasury. So now requirements, yes, Aadhaar card for biometrics, then the mobile number registered with the Aadhaar card, because the OTP will come on that mobile. So let us see how it is done. So digital rights certificate generation. Let us see now. I am going to be slow here because this is something we have to explain properly. So now see, this can be done at home or with the agency. At home means you need that biometric device at home. So otherwise, I told you, government is so many, they have appointed agents, they do it. Now here one question I see people asking, that do I have to buy, suppose I want to do it home, do I have to buy that device because my phone has my fingerprint recognition? So can I use my phone? Now please remember, phone has fingerprint recognition, fingerprint lock, but that is local. So if I put my finger on the phone, it will see my, it will scan it, and it will recognize whether it is my finger or somebody's finger. But that remains with him. It is a local thing, that yes, it is your fingerprint or no. Phone is cannot send it to the Jeevan Praman Center. Okay, so for that there is a device which one has to buy if you want to do it home. But otherwise agency people are there and they do it. They are government authorized, nothing to worry. So now Aadhaar card is required for biometric verifications. Now let us start the process, how to fill the form. So provide your details like PPO, treasury, etc. Now I have shown this smiley here. He is wearing glasses. So what I mean is, wear your glasses and give everything in detail. We know already that if I make mistake here, then there will be a mistake for the treasury to locate me. So please do this in detail. Now, as soon as Aadhaar verifies your biometrics, so now what happens when Aadhaar verifies your biometric? Aadhaar will say that this is a person and these are his fingerprints, and because he is able to give the fingerprint, he is alive. Fine. Your digital certificate is generated. Now what happens when it is generated? Agency will give you a copy of your DLC. Copy means soft, hard copy. I'm not talking of soft copy. Hard copy means a paper of your DLC. And DLC will automatically go to your treasury. This I am saying, but we will prove that it goes. Now one more thing, huh? He will give you a copy of your DLC. So people are happy that my DLC is there and it is in front of them. So now let us look at the DLC, how it looks. Then we have to talk of something important here. Now, yes, I forgot about this, that when he gives you, when he generates and give you, that time you will get SMS on your mobile. This is most important. Which mobile you will get? The same mobile on which you get OTP for your Aadhaar card. Now, what is written in that SMS? This is most important, okay? And don't delete that SMS, keep it with you. Now, see, this SMS comes, thank you for successfully submitting your digital life certificate. Your Praman ID means your digital life certificate. See, they will be generating for so many people, no? So then your digital ID, your Praman ID is something, 10 digit number. It can be any number which is given to you. Any means not random number, but it is random, but once it is given, it is yours. Now see here, I have written 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, because I don't want to write any number here. Who knows if it belongs to somebody. So to be on safe side, I have given this. But of course, just now I thought that even this number may belong to somebody. But if it belongs to somebody, please excuse me. Okay, and if that person happens to see this video, please excuse me. I had no intention to give your number. Okay, so now you may view life certificate online at, see, you can view your, even though you are given a copy, you can view them online on this site. What is this site? HTTPS, then /, then G1, Praman, etc. I have written here, okay? Now, this comes on your mobile, okay? So, you don't have to remember, this will be with your mobile. Anytime you want to see which is the site, you can click on this in your mobile. You will immediately go on that site. So it is very easy to use mobile and get to the site and this Praman ID. Huh? Now I will tell you when we use this. So your digital life certificate will be processed by pension disbursing agency for release of pension. What is a pension disbursing agency? It is our treasury. That means this also, this SMS which has come by from the government is also telling that it will be processed by your treasury. That means it has to be processed, but there is one more proof that it has gone to the treasury. So let us see now. So is it clear? Please never delete this SMS from your phone. Keep it, and I am going to use it in this video also today. So let us see now how your life certificate looks. See, your life certificate looks like this. This is the first part, but I am going to talk of second part just now. See, I am going to talk of this part first, then I will talk of the upper part. Now see, this is you give your Aadhaar number. Again here, the Aadhaar number will be blank because of privacy reasons. And then only last four digits will come. I have just written 1, 2, 3, 4. Your name will come, whatever is in Aadhaar. Your date of birth will come. Again, last four digits only will come. You know that. Now pension slips we have done. I have explained everything. Your mobile number also, again last four digits. Everywhere I am writing 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And your picture will be there. Okay. Your picture will not be blank because of privacy reason. Your picture will be there. Okay. So now this is Aadhaar. What is this? Aadhaar has done its job. Aadhaar says that this is a person, this is a picture, this is his number, and I have seen his biometrics matching. That means he is alive today. Correct? So this is Aadhaar's job. See here, suppose this was on 2/11. Again, this is a random date I have put. Okay. I just put any date. So now this Aadhaar says that this person with all these blah 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 is alive on 2/11/2021 and at this time and this hour and second and minute and whatnot. And his Praman ID, which was in that SMS, is here. That is fine. Aadhaar says you are alive. And now your certificate will go to the treasury. Correct? Now treasury has to locate you, that you are there with them. How does the treasury locate you? Your name is there, which you have to give correct. Huh? What is there in there? Your PPO. Now your PPO order. Now tell me, you will say, oh, name is there, so treasury, no. First of all, your treasury, you should not make mistake in writing, but your PPO number is the unique number which will identify. See, names can be same, but the PPO number cannot be same. So treasury cannot identify you unless your PPO is correct. Again, I am saying your PPO number should be correct, and of course your name etc. should be written properly. Now, how do we know that this is going to the treasury? Please see this disclaimer here. This disclaimer I will show you in the next slide, where I have highlighted the disclaimer and you can see. So first of all, if your PPO is wrong by mistake, then the treasury cannot identify you. Aadhaar says you are alive, but treasury doesn't know whether you belong to their treasury. Okay, if you write wrong PPO, the maybe somebody else. So then how can treasury continue your pension? And therefore, if the treasury rejects this, your pension will be stopped. And that is why maybe the agents and all are telling, they may not know why it is stopped. They will tell you, no, 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 send it to the treasury, send it to the treasury, which is not required. Now see one more thing. So this is about this PPO number. Yes, let me tell you, generally pensioners don't make mistake. They know that they have to write correct number. Maybe the person who is typing for you, there can be a human error, but generally that also doesn't happen because they are also very responsible person. Most of the time I found that this number or the certificate was rejected because the pensioner order number was changed. Now there is a rule that whenever a pensioner order PPO number changes for whatever reason, the bank has to inform the pensioner that your PPO number is so and so. But many times it is not informed. Even if it is informed, pensioner sometimes he is worried which payment order I should write, the first one or the new one. So if there is a mistake here, which one you have to write? You have to write the current one. So if this number is wrong, then your certificate, your treasury will not locate you and your certificate will be rejected. First, let me read this disclaimer in the next slide. I am not scaring, I am not saying that this will be rejected. These cases can be 1 in 10,000. But we don't want to be trapped in that 1 in 10,000 cases, no? That is why I am saying. Now see, note the important aspect of DLC. Now here you can read the DLC. The DLC says, what is the disclaimer? The digital life certificate will be subject to acceptance by your pension processing center, Maharashtra State Treasury. Now this one I got from Palghar. So I have written Palghar. This is a computer generated certificate and does not require signature. That we know. All computer generated documents are like this. But see, important. This certificate is subject to acceptance by the treasury. That means this certificate is going to the treasury. Otherwise, how they will subject to acceptance? They will say, oh, done, sent. So this is certain. This is a proof that it is going to the treasury. This is one. Secondly, if this has to be accepted, when it will be accepted? Generally the mistake is in the PPO number. So, and that is because of confusion. So now see, one thing is certain from the above disclaimer, your DLC has reached the treasury. Now let us see what the treasury has to say about it. See, this is subject to the acceptance, means what the treasury has to say. We want to know whether treasury has accepted me or not accepted, correct? No. So let us see what the treasury has to say about it. So please take on. Now how do you know what treasury is saying? You can't phone the treasury that now tell me, they have a lot of work. He will say okay, okay, then he will go on searching. That is not possible. So how do you check whether, what is the status of your life certificate, whether the treasury is accepted or rejected? Now again on Jeevan Praman site, if you see the frequently asked questions, the Jeevan Praman has said that this, after generating the life certificate, you don't have to worry. If your certificate is accepted by the treasury, treasury will send you SMS. If it is rejected by the treasury, then also they will send you SMS. But so far I asked so many people, nobody has got any SMS. So therefore they don't know whether it is accepted or not. So what they will do now, see what one has to do, because instead of waiting for the SMS, it is better that we start finding out what is happening. So how do we find out? So now see here, the third one. So please keep on checking, huh? Because somewhere we used to hear, no, when we were young, apply, apply, no reply. So that is why if there is no reply, no SMS, we keep on checking the status of your life certificate, whether it is accepted or rejected. How do you check it? So for checking, you will keep on downloading the life certificate till you receive the reply. Now keep on downloading means what? You don't have to again go to the agent and again pay him those 70 rupees and say that download for me. It is very, very easy to download from the phone, and I will show you how to download. Correct? So what happens is after a few days, maybe 10-20 days, you can check. Now see, you will worry that it is electronically sent. So it is sent on the same day, same time. Correct? It is sent on the same second. Why same time, same minute? But what Treasury do, that is again written on the frequently asked question, that it is immediately sent to the Treasury electronically. But Treasury also busy. So what they do, they go on downloading it from there in parts, that means in batches. So suppose I send it today, you also send today, somebody sends tomorrow. They may be downloading after every 10 days, every 15 days, etc. So then that is why you have to wait when they will be downloading, correct? So now what it will do, keep on downloading till you receive the reply. So I am showing you how to download. So see, how to download, this is very simple. I am giving that SMS again, okay? I have shown it again. Recall that SMS received on your mobile while generating the DLC. I had said that time that this is very important. Never erase it, never delete it. We can't erase from the phone, sorry. Never delete it from the phone, keep it. Now what is here? They have this site address. So you don't have to type the site address. You are on the mobile only. This is SMS on the mobile. So just click on it. When you click on it, mobile will take you to that site. This site mobile will take you, because when you type it in whatever you have, other device, computer and all, you have to be careful. So even I saw that, oh, it is very easy. So I just clicked on it and I went to the site. Now your Jeevan Praman ID is important because it is attached to your life certificate, correct? So please note down the Jeevan Praman ID, because the phone screen, phone display will take you to the site. So then how you will know the Praman? So please write it down temporarily, of course, and then click on this. So you will go on the site, correct? So now let us see what happens when you go to the site. So how the site looks, see, I'll show you. The site looks like this. Downloading the DLCs. See, what you downloaded was on the first day when you submitted, but the disclaimer is going to change, no? Yes or no? When the Treasury will check. That is why we are downloading. And which download I will get? I will get the latest download on my DLC, not the one which I submitted. But DLC will be same, the number will be same, correct? So now see, you are on this one. Pensioner sign in, he will take you to this site, correct? Now see here, Praman ID. That Praman ID I said, no, you please write down somewhere so that you can fill here. So see, enter Praman ID is written here. So please fill that. Just now I have written just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever. So you fill your Praman ID here. Now what about the CAPTCHA? You already know pension slip you have done and you are very much, used to that CAPTCHA. So please type the CAPTCHA as it is. See, enter the CAPTCHA exactly as it appears. So if it is capital, you write capital. If it is not capital, write like that. Okay. So now after doing this, he will ask you confirmation code. That means you are the one who is searching. See, I can't come and I will say, okay, show me her DLC. I can't do it. So he must know that you are the same person. So how do he will know you are the same person? Same OTP on your mobile, which is connected with Aadhaar, correct? So now see here, you have to click on generate OTP. So it will immediately give you the OTP which you have to put in the confirmation code. So that OTP you put, it will, that means it is sure that you are not a machine, you are a human being because of CAPTCHA. Your Praman ID is correct, of course, and then OTP is there. So then he will take you to the screen where he will give your name also. Hi, so and so, you want to download your LIC? Then of course you click on that, yes. Otherwise, why I will come on the site, isn't it? So then he will say hello, so and so and all, and then download. So when we download the LIC, I will, not LIC, I am sorry, DLC, I will get the current DLC which will be same, but only the status will be different. So let us see if I have downloaded. Where am I? I am here. Everything will be same. The status is here, which was there. Now, if it is still disclaimer, that means what? The treasury has still not downloaded it from in the batch. Your number has not come. It is like, you know, you are in the queue, so you have to wait. Sometimes when we call some people, some bank or some big thing, they will say you are in the queue, you are in the queue. So you have to understand you are in the queue. Doesn't matter. You have to try your luck next time. Try after 2-3 more days or 1 week or so. Now if this is changed, see here, it might have changed to accepted. Accepted means what? Done. Everything is correct. Your everything was correct here. It is accepted and your pension is going to be continued. Finish. Enjoy, celebrate and be happy. But it might have changed to this, not accepted. They will give the reason and they will tell you to see the treasury. So if it is not accepted, then what happens? You have to see the treasury. They will go with your ID proof and they will tell you what is your mistake. And once you know your mistake, next time you are not going to do that mistake. So for the entire life, your this life certificate mistake will remind you that no, now there is no mistake. So next time it is going to be accepted because you will not make that mistake again, isn't it? So let us see how, what are the various formats of, or not formats, what are the various forms of disclaimer we get in the next one. So see, note the important aspect of DLC, disclaimer, the digital, this is the original disclaimer, correct? Now, it may be this, your digital life certificate has not been accepted by Maharashtra State Treasury Palghar. If your treasury will tell you, okay, whichever is yours, I just filled anything, Palghar, Pune and anything. So it will tell you that reason is here. Now this reason I feel very stupid because he says due to unknown. That means what is unknown? The reason is unknown to the treasury or unknown to me or unknown to what? But don't bother. Anyway, you have to go to the pension processing authority or treasury. You will have to personally go there and they will tell you what has happened. Now, please remember, if it is not accepted, it is rejected. So there is no point of sending the same DLC again and again and again. You are creating trash at the treasury because whatever is rejected, treasury is cannot accept it only. So you will have to go personally there and they will tell you also. See, here he has written unknown, but they will tell you what is your mistake. Most of the cases, it is a PPO which has changed for some treasuries, I think so. So they will tell you and then, as I told you, you will remember forever. Now second is, let us take something happy. Your digital life certificate has been successfully accepted by treasury. I thought this is from Pune, so I said okay, this person must be from Pune. So now he is very happy, done, finished, and the pension will be coming. The third case is what? See, here they have written, at least some reason is given, PPO mismatch, but mostly it is PPO mismatch only. That is what I feel. So then please contact your pension processing authority. So once you contact them, they will tell you that what is a mistake. And yes, I forgot, once you contact them, then you don't have to again go to the agent for a new DLC with the new corrected PPO. No, you are at the treasury. And those people are also very nice. They will tell you now that you are here, Please fill in the form here. They will give you the form, the same form, okay? That loose sheet, but you are at the treasury, so it's not going to be misplaced. They will give you the form and they will tell you, please fill in just now. We will sign and we are taking it here, we are accepting and everything will be fine. So once you go to the treasury, please fill in there only, okay? Everything will be nice and everything will be good. So let us see now. And yes, please, when you give it, don't ask him for acknowledgement, okay? Otherwise it will be no good, you know, because first of all, it is not mandatory for them to give the acknowledgement from their table. If any acknowledgement, any, I'm not talking of this, you want from the treasury, the only way is in the inward office, you have to give with a covering letter, and the inward, there some pune or clerk will be there, he will give you. But for this, when you are going personally, you don't need any such thing. Okay, so now your DLC is complete, everything is all right and fine. Now I want to mention about this. This is coming so many times in newspapers that everybody will be knowing about this. Pensioners will know, but even I am saying their grandchildren will also know about this DSB by public sector banks and post office and all that. See, what happens is DSB is doorstep banking. This is public sector banks. Some 12 public sector banks have come together and they do this because if the pensioner is not able to come to the bank or go to the agent also, suppose he is bedridden, he is not well, and mainly sometimes it is really difficult, and this was already there, but during COVID also this was very useful because senior citizen may not want to come out, correct? No? So then this doorstep banking is by public sector banks or post office, a postman comes. Now how do they verify that you are the same person and you are, this is your blah blah blah, you are alive? Again, it is the same Aadhaar based life certificates to help the pensioners who are not able to reach the bank or the DLC authorized center to submit their life certificate. The process is very similar to DSC. This is very nice. The government did this for benefit of everyone. There is only one problem here. If somebody doesn't have Aadhaar or some problem with Aadhaar card, then this is not going to work. Even the DLC which we mentioned earlier will not work. Then he will have to go and find out what. He has to go to the branch of his bank which is nearby. But it is okay. And when the new video conferencing life certificate is coming fast, isn't it? That time at least Aadhaar is not there, because I saw the steps and there they were saying that pensioner has to show his PAN card or something in the video conference call. That means that will be good for everyone, and everybody is used to video call and everybody has mobile. So once I think that comes, every other thing may become redundant. I have no idea. We will know it next year, the time will tell, but I think that is the best. So now let us see. We conclude our first video on the life certificate of pensioners. Now what remains is the next video is about the submission of this remains of the life certificate of pensioners from abroad. See, there are some pensioners who have gone abroad to meet their children, or and then they are stuck there because of COVID restrictions. How will they submit? Some pensioners have relocated abroad. Some pensioners have taken, yes, I want to mention that here. Some pensioners have taken citizenship of other countries. This I want to mention. Everybody must be knowing, but I thought I should mention. Even if you take citizenship of other country, your pension is not going to be stopped. Of course, life certificate you have to give, but the pension will not stop that now you have left India, so your Indian pension you will not get, because pension is that is a Supreme Court judgment that pension is not a bounty, it is not a charity, it is your reward of your hard work. So even if you take citizenship of other country, your pension will come. So then they have to submit the life certificate. Most of the people who are abroad, they know how to submit. So this may take only 5 minutes to tell. But even then, now I want to conclude this video. I want the next video, which is important. See, this I will write, I will say because for completion of the topic. But the important in the next video is the following. See, this is important. This is not, this is for every pensioner, whether he is abroad, whether he is here or he is anywhere. Okay. So this I want to suggest. See, we would also like to suggest. This is for the next video. And I would be happy if everybody sees and then we can do something about this. We would also like to suggest some additional features, which will further ease the pressure of every pensioner from India or abroad. Because there are some features, some little change in the program which is written, which is very simple, but it will definitely help all of us. So we want to suggest that to the concerned authority, some suggestions, okay? And if those suggestions, if they are implemented, and they will be implemented, because it is not a great demand, slight change in the program, then it will be very useful to each of us. See, for every pensioner from India, okay, and abroad of course, but for every pensioner from India, right? So in short, the next video is going to be a wish list for the comfort of each one of us. So please, I feel that it will be good if you see that, because it will be useful. So now this video is over. I'm concluding it. I have already concluded. So see you soon and best of luck for your life certificates. Okay. So goodbye.